built to be played in a nice resounding building like a church, and the violin can cope with a similar surrounding as well. This is an early 17th century lute, and this is a 17th century mandora, which is a kind of ancestor of the mandolin, and or, as you might say, it's just a treble lute, you could also say. And we're going to play three pieces of music from a manuscript, which makes it sound very grand. It was actually, almost certainly, a boy of about 12 years old, his music book. You would keep a music book, your music teacher, your music tutor would give you a tune to play every week, and it would all be written out by hand, and you'd see how you got on with it by the next week, just like nowadays. And this book has survived, and it's a very interesting source for what you might call domestic music. Now, the first tune we're going to play is called "Play Lendy to Dance," which survives nowadays as a nursery rhyme and is also the tune to a dance called the cushion dance. And it goes in two halves. The first half is played as an allemande, and the second half is played as a jig, which is more like the way we know the tune nowadays. I think there's something else to say where we make a point to that we're in tune together. This is the kind of music that you would play in your house of an evening. You might have an audience of 2, 3, 5, possibly even just double figures. So you've got to imagine a much smaller surrounding than here. And I do hope that you will be able to hear at the back. Thank you. remembered doesn't come from the scheme language. It comes from a slightly earlier book written by someone called Duncan Burnett. And it was written for keyboard. But we like to include it because the ancient Gaelic tradition of harp playing died out completely in Scotland in the 18th century, and it was changed so much in Ireland that what's left of it in Ireland, you can hardly recreate how the original music might have sounded, except for a few fragments that have been written down in keyboard books and in lute books. And the one we're going to play now is a typical one of these ancient harp tunes. However, it has a Scottish or an English title. I don't mind which you call it. I was reminded at lunch today that Voltaire had said that the science of linguistics is one where the consonants matter little and the vowels not at all. We call it As I Come Doon Be the Wetter Side. If you prefer to call it As I Came Down By the Water Side, very well. Thank you. back to rather larger instruments now, perhaps a little bit more suited to building of this size. And for this trio by Haydn, it's known as, well, there are a set of three trios called the London Trios, because they were written when Haydn came on a visit to London. Always forget to look up my history before I come on a conference like this. I think it was in 1795. And I believe at the time, you can imagine Haydn coming from a part of Europe where the largest piece of water was the Neusiedler See. He would be interested in ships. And he actually took several days off so that he could visit Portsmouth, where he made sketches of the British fleet in the harbour at Portsmouth from above the water, where he could look over Portsmouth, from Portsmouth down, he could look over the harbour there. And I don't know whether his drawings of ships survived, but it's interesting to think that he took the time off. Probably harder to travel from London to Portsmouth in those days than it was for us to travel from Scotland to the south of England yesterday. And what he did, and to satisfy his curiosity about the Navy. And when he wasn't doing that anyway, he did many things, which also included writing these trios, of which the one we're going to play now is one of them.
Thank you. The same machine that videoed Figaro and Susanna.
It is.
Well, that's jolly good. I must look at it. I've only looked at it once, like most of my video things, but I must look at it again.
Yes, indeed. And also the Messiah.
Oh, yes, I saw that one. Yes, of course I did. I saw a bit of that. It was very good.
It's done some fascinating programs of which this will be absolutely up at the top.
Will it be possible to get a copy of it?
Of course, I shall do. I shall do a copy for whoever would like one.
Do you have an actual copying machine?
Well, you see, what I do is play it through the camera.
Yes.
And attach it to the video recorder.
Oh,
into
yes.
Which I put a blank, large.
Oh, I see.
Video.
Yes. Oh, yes. Yes.
So it's really very easy to do.
Yes. Yes. Oh, that's wonderful.
So I could do one for anybody who wanted one.
Super. Well, I think we'd love one.
I'm looking forward to focusing on your. I'm looking forward to focusing on the stops. Will it put you off if I?
No. No. Of course not. I'm here to. Never let them. I want to rehearse a little bit with Lucy, just so that she. I need her to like a great to pedal, because there isn't a pedal to do that. You know,
quite.
Most organs have a piston, but it hasn't, and so I need her help, like a conjurer. There's a young lady in the audience who
would be lovely. I hope you'll see that.
I think he's going to is this?
Real Dieter Downs.
What's it called?
Real Dieter Downs.
Can you not come and sit in here?
I can't see the feet.
I think that's better. Because otherwise, it'll be. Just kidding. Well, except that if it's only you sitting there, that's all right, isn't it? Because. No, it should be fine.
It should be all right.
The only people who are going to be sitting there are the players. So, so if Christina sits here, Kim's playing, or whoever's not playing,
I think Lucy's going to wait till I'm late.
Yes, then it won't be in the way.
Say applause after each item. Shall we say? Applause after each item.
Oh, I think so,
yes.
Yes.
Only I need to say that, because otherwise people have funny feelings about clapping in churches.
Yes.
I will say, but we will...
Quite a good thing.
We will...
I think it gives us a sort of...
Yes. Good. This thing is a zoom for close-ups. Thank you.
in music school. Or what you're seeing in Winchester.
Yes.
Because it's not very far. Yes. And you don't know where to look, and you have to empty a cupboard and fill up all the room. It's very nice.
Christina,
yes.
Can we have you to play?
You think I should
play?
Yeah, I don't know if I don't know.
Of course you should.
I don't know if I want to do it.
Don't you?
Can't not.
No, I thought I'd go on strike.
Yes, I should do that.
Yes.
Hold them to it.
Yes.
Thank you. Ha ha ha!